Hey everyone, I'm Jaseem. You can, thankfully I have a unique name, so you can just Google and find everything about me, Jaseem Abed. And as of now, I work at a company called Idea Device, where we build a bunch of awesome stuff with Python. Yeah, you can probably come and talk to us. So yeah, I'd like to share something small. I was just outside and Romchi comes to me and say, hey, you should probably do a meetup, a talk about the recent stuff you've been doing. I see some familiar faces too. So it's opinionated. I know probably some of you guys are going to throw stones at me. Please don't. I don't want that to happen. I'm going to talk about Emacs. It's and it's going to be in 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Yeah, sure. This all starts when recently moved to Bangalore. I've been going to a lot of random meetups, conferences, everything. I go to meetup.com and I type Lisp. And nothing shows up. Nothing shows up in a 100-mile radius. Then I type Emacs. Nothing shows up. I type even Vim. Nothing shows up. Then I'm like, okay, this is not right. There are so many people using it. Actually, even nothing for Sublime, nothing. Think about it. I mean, what more as a program? I'm not talking about Excel managers. Like, it's the tool you use the most, right? You will find like a million tutorials on Bash, Zshell, everything. But, you know, ultimately, it's the editor you use the most, right? So I thought, you know, I'll give a quick talk about it. So a very few features, the important ones. I'm not going into the Lisp macros and things like that. It's a very powerful editor per se. I mean, highlighted editor part. You know, you can type text, edit text, copy text efficiently. Probably that's the one thing you want out of an editor, and this can do it well. You know, and the more important part is you get that everywhere, almost everywhere. So the reason being, you know, let's say you're happy with Sublime, right? When you want to type a mail, you don't have that thing at all. So you're comfortably editing in whatever thing you are, let's say Sublime, Emacs, Vim, even Gedit or Nano. And if you're happy with it, you don't have it to type a mail or, you know, just edit your own expenses or budget or whatever. So that's one place where I like it. I can just do all my things there. And yeah, once you get the thing, it's quite fun to use. It's not as bad as it sounds. And yeah, we don't do key bindings with 10 keys. The whole thing like control 1, 2, 8, B, meta G, and nobody does that, you know. And it's versatile. You can do crazy lot of things. The Git integration is awesome. I'm even doing my slides in Emacs, and it just took me like 5 minutes to hack it up. So that, and it's constantly evolving. It's 37 years old. I am 22. It's like almost double my age. And it's still rocking, right? Like, I don't think we have many softwares that old. You know, but it's modern. For example, the idea of a built-in package manager, it's a pretty much modern idea, right? At least for a text editor. Yes, Aptitude is there. So even though it's like a very old thing, it is evolving in its own way. There's a package manager and a bunch of things like that. It can be mouseless. You don't do that. Do you? And yeah, it works well with tools because when people write their own tools, for example, Ctax, Mail Client Shell, the people who wrote it 20 years back most probably would have been this. Most famous examples would be Yukihiro Matsumoto, the guy who made Ruby. He is like so much of an Emacs fan. There's a story in which he tried the curly braces once, and you know, then he kind of managed to make Emacs understand the Ruby syntax. And like, yeah, now I'm sure this is the syntax I want to go. If Emacs didn't support it, Ruby would have had curly braces today. That would have been bad, right? So yeah, and it's cross-platform, runs on toy operating systems, then Linux, it runs on Mac too. And it's hackable. This is the idea. So it's a Lisp machine. So the whole idea is like, why would you hack your editor? What's the whole time point? So it's like, carpenters never tweak their tools, right? So why would they? Probably the only, one of my friends said, you know, the only difference is a carpenter cannot, even if he really want to, change his blade into something else. We as programmers, I think we are probably lucky to, you know, tweak our tools the way we want. So that could be the reason why. And the fundamental idea being, you know, it's just fun. Cool, I heard that. How? It's a Lisp machine. It's the old Lisp machine people have been talking since 70s. It's like the real world thing. And yeah, the idea is we run a meetup. Idea Device, my company, we just hosted the last meetup a week back. I'll zoom in that. So I welcome you to, you know, go there and possible, if possible, come for the next meetup, or, you know, I might be around, come and meet up. And I don't want a Vim war. And yeah, that's it. Thank you. Oh. we support Unicode too. Yeah, that's the thing. You have 1 minute to ask a question, if any. Thank you.